All stories have a beginning. And in order to understand this story, that is where we need to start. You could say that this story is the beginning of all other beginnings. You see, it's the story of us. And it was in that beginning, in the dawn of time, that God created the heavens and the earth. God separated the darkness from the light. And God began to form the world and made everything in it. He was hovering over the waters of the void earth and formed the mountains, the prairies, and all other landforms. He made the fish in the sea and the fowl of the air. But he saved his most precious, important creation for last. He formed from the dust of the earth man, which he crafted in his own image. He breathed into the man his eternal spirit of life, and the man began to breathe for the first time. Pleased with his creation, God said it was good. God brought the man every animal on earth to be named. The man named the fish of the sea and all the fowl in the air. But God saw that it was not good for man to be alone, so he caused the man to go into a deep sleep. And from the man's own side, God fashioned the most beautiful creature, woman. The man rejoiced to see such a creation and said, "This is bone of my bone and flesh of my own flesh." After God saw the man was pleased, he placed the man and woman in the garden he had made for them. In the garden, God placed a tree of knowledge and told the man not to eat from that tree. For the man and woman were like children in their innocence and did not have the maturity for such knowledge yet. But something happened in the garden that was not part of the plan. Darkness crept into the garden and drew the woman and the man close to the tree of knowledge. And then the darkness turned into a great serpent, like a jealous brother of the gifts God had bestowed upon the man and woman. The serpent wanted to destroy what God had made. So the serpent tricked the man and woman to eat the fruit of the tree of knowledge. Immediately they saw that they were naked and were ashamed of what they had done. They had disobeyed God. God was their life, their eternal security. But in that moment, the moment they took the first bite of the fruit, the darkness entered the man. Now this darkness is known by many names, but its eternal name is death. Death was born into humanity, and darkness crept into the hearts of humans. The human immortal spirit lost its immortality and died. Without the life of God sustaining humanity, the human biological body began to decay and die. Although death biologically did not take place right away, from the time of human birth, humans now begin to die. Outraged with the serpent for perverting his creation, God cast the serpent out of his presence. And now, because man had disobeyed God, God, who is light and life, could no longer be where darkness and death was. So the man and woman had to leave the presence of God. God wept for his creation. And the man and woman were ever looking for the life which they now had lost. God continued to work out a plan to rescue his lost creation. But will it have any effect? How could death be defeated? The day death was born seemed to be the day that all creation lost its hope. We have been left to death, and all hope is lost. Or is it?
Is I alone? Is I alone?